glory.
Amen.
Bless him. Amen. Amen. Redemption.
Even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Everything was made by him and made for him. All the celestial bodies, all the heavens, all the earth. Christ is the default position of creation. Walking in Christ is returning to one's true self. Christ represents the perfection of creation. That the guiding of the devil that turned man's heart from God and from his perfect nature.
Amen.
He said the mystery of God was hidden. Hidden from the ages and the generations, which has now been restored through Christ. The mystery of Christ, the mystery of God is Christ in us. The restoration of the soul. I'm not perfect.
Christ.
But I am presented perfect through Christ.
Through Christ.
God sees Christ in us.
Amen.
Making us acceptable before him.
Amen.
Bless him.
Amen.
Bless him. Bless him. Bless him.
Bless your son.
Bless him, Lord. My Lord.
Thou hast been in Eden,
the garden of God.
Thou art the anointed cherub that covereth. And I have set thee so, thou wast upon the anointed, the holy mountain of God. Thou hast walked up and down in the midst of the stones of fire. Thou was perfect in thy ways, from thy day, thou was created till iniquity was found in thee. On account of the multitude of thy comers, thy inside was filled with wrong, and thou didst sin. I will therefore profane thee away from the mountain of God, and destroy thee, O covering cherub, away from the fiery soldiers. At the same time, as revealing the nature of the ruler of fire's heart, he prophesies, or he reveals, the fall of Satan.
Amen.
His king really was.
That's right.
Praise his name.
The ruler of Tyre's king was Satan.
secured perfect in our
He was on the holy mountain of God, which is the heavens.
Amen.
In the midst of the stones of fire, which represents his high position in the heavenly realms.
Glory, glory.
The fiery stones could represent the planets,
which
he's cast away from.
Yes.
The planets are represented on the blessed breastplate of the high priest in the form of the 12 stones.
My Lord.
Satan was perfect.
Nine planets.
He lifted up his heart. Be careful, brethren, about jumping on your high horse.
That's right.
Until you know that it's God's will.
Amen.
Too many people want to speak on things that they have no knowledge and understanding.
That's right.
And actually end up doing the devil's
will.
Right. That's
right. Rather than God's.
Amen.
My Lord.
Amen.
Jesus, amen.
Blessing.
All right, here we go. The allure of Satan. Behold, the Assyrian was a cedar in Lebanon, with fair branches, and with a shadow shroud of a high stature, and his top was among the thick boughs. The waters made him great, and he set him up on high, with her rivers running around about his plants, and set her little rivers unto all the trees of the field. Thus he was in his greatness in the length of his branches, for his root was by great waters. The cedars in the garden of God could not hide it. The fir trees were not like his boughs, and the chestnut trees were not like his branches. For any tree in the garden of God was like unto him in his beauty. I have made him fair by the multitude of his branches, so that all the trees of Eden that were in the garden of God envied him. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, because thou hast lifted up thyself in might, and he hath shot up his top among the thick boughs, and his heart is lifted up in his height. Satan's wisdom is beautiful.
It is beautiful.
It's beautiful. He was created perfect. There is no wonder that he beguiles so many in this world today. Amen.
Amen.
Ezekiel is prophesying to the king of Egypt. And he draws another parallel to another kingdom, the Assyrian kingdom. The waters represent the knowledge of God. The waters made him great. Deep set him up on high, and rivers running round about his front. The waters represent the knowledge of God.
Bless him.
The waters represent the knowledge of God. His root was by great waters. Amen. There was no tree like Satan in the garden of God. No wonder he started to exalt himself. He was envied by the other trees, and he corrupted the earth.
My Lord.
Be careful putting people on a pedestal, brethren.
Right.
Amen. Because it may be fundamental to their demise.
Jesus.
Always remember the one who created. Always acknowledge him in all your ways, and humble yourself, or you be exalted.
Amen.
No matter how good and appealing your kingdom looks, does not mean that it's a force for good.
Thank you.
Just because they speak nice, and they dress nice, and they conduct themselves in a certain way, they can still be in opposition to God.
Amen.
Why do I say question everything you hear on the news? Take it to God. Take it to Jesus before you repeat it or embrace it.
True.
Do these. Do these current superpowers have God's best interest at heart?
No.
They don't.
No, they don't.
Do they put themselves up on a mantelpiece as a beacon of democracy?
Yes, they do.
Yet they're involved in so much wickedness.
Corruption.
They are. They're involved in, the European Union and the United Nations. They're involved in so much wickedness and atrocity that has gone on in the world for the last two centuries. You don't have to have time to even talk about it. So be mindful about what you digest spiritually, because Satan is the master of deception.
Yes, he is.
He is the master of deception.
Sin is a bad environment.
Amen.
If you're interested in the environment, respectful, get an understanding and then acquire knowledge to the subject. I'm not that knowledgeable on the subject of the environment, so I'm going to present the scripture as best as I can.
Amen.
God flooded the earth because of sin.
Amen.
God caused the destruction of the earth.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
If we confess our sin and turn towards God, He'll redeem creation. God will bless the inheritance He has reserved for
you. Yield their land.
Turn to Him in obedience.
Amen.
The best way to redeem creation is to win souls and teach them the good way.
Hear God. Amen.
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 Christians.
Created He them in the image of God.
And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth,
replenish.
And have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing.
Stewardship.
Upon the earth.
Amen.
God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree, in which is the fruit of the tree.
Blessing.
Wherein there is life, I have given every green herb from meat.
I've given it to you.
Solo.
Yes.
Good. Very good.
This is a discussion between the Godhead.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen. I've given it to
God
you.
Said, let us make man in our image.
Yeah.
The image of God, His Spirit.
Spirit.
This passage is the creation of man.
Yeah.
At this stage, man has not been given a body.
No.
Amen.
Amen.
He has not been created from the
not
God.
Yet.
No.
Let
he
us create man.
Man and female, as is God, and His Spirit.
His Spirit.
His Spirit.
His Spirit. So.
There's no marriage in heaven.
Therefore, a soul. The word.
Amen.
A soul. There's soul.
There's soul. God has commanded man in spirit.
Creature.
Amen. God affirms man in the spirit before he manifests
in the flesh. That's right.
We have to affirm things in the spirit
before
it manifests physically.
Thank you.
We need to teach our children in the spirit.
Yes.
How do we know what to do in God's creation?
Amen.
God's will, not man's will.
Spirit of life,
amen.
Quickly and power of God.
The earth and its resources are made from man.
Spirit.
They are made from man. Spiritually, we are commanded to replenish, multiply, and be fruitful.
In the spirit.
In the spirit, amen. Animals are made for man.
Yeah.
Don't let man dictate whether or not you should eat meat or drive petrol cars. Take it to God in the spirit.
Yeah.
Take
Once
it to the Lord.
Revelation and understand the subject, apply knowledge, and present your case to the necessary people.
Yeah.
It's that
Bless him.
Inquire with God.
Inquire of the Lord.
Or drive in electric cars. There is nothing covered that shall not be revealed.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit is all truth, not just scriptural truth.
All things. Spirit of life.
So ask God if we should try and decarbonize the earth.
Yeah.
Acquire knowledge and understanding rather than putting faith in an ungodly counsel.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So, you know,
what about your soul? Yes.
God knows the truth. God is the truth. Amen. Daniel 3. Amen.
Amen.
I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the ancients of days did sit, whose garment was as white as snow, and the hair of his head was like a pure wood.
Yes.
His throne was like a fiery flame, and his wheels as burning fire.
Yes.
As concerning the rest of the beasts, they have their dominion taken away,
yes,
yet their lives were prolonged for a season and time.
Mm-hmm.
And there was given him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations,
and tongues
should serve him.
Yes.
His dominion is an everlasting kingdom that shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever. Amen. So Daniel had a dream,
yes,
in which there were four beasts on the earth.
Yes.
The four beasts on the earth represent four kingdoms.
Four kingdoms, yeah.
The fourth beast was in particular diverse from the rest.
Mm-hmm.
Daniel stayed in the dream until he saw the Ancient of Days. And then Daniel was having a revelation of the millennial reign.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Where Christ comes and establishes an everlasting kingdom,
yeah,
here on the earth.
Yeah,
here on the earth.
Here on this earth.
It's time to prepare for this millennium.
Oh.
It's time to prepare for the kingdom of God.
No.
To start putting ourselves in a position where we can take over institutions, where we can have influence in the world, because Christ will take over the kingdoms of men.
Amen.
He will.
Yes, he will. Amen.
There's 10 kingdoms. It makes me think of the European Union,
yes,
and the United Nations.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The kingdom of his dear son, which we are already partakers in, will destroy the kingdom of the four beasts. I genuinely believe this is the era I'm living in, because I don't think there's been a beast that has been as bad as this one that we've witnessed over the past few centuries. This beast has been destroying the earth, and Jesus will destroy those who destroy the earth.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to affirm victory in the spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Before we win in the hospitals, in the schools, in the church, and ultimately in the world, we have to acknowledge the kingdom of God spiritually now.
Amen.
We have to acknowledge that Jesus is going to take over the kingdom of God. And then we have to say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
For the transformation that he's made in our lives.
Bless him.
Amen.
You must digest this word spiritually. Understand it and apply knowledge to it. Water it. Prepare for it. Because it's happening.
Amen.
It's going to happen.
Mm.
It's going to happen. And he said, as his stature one cubit. If he then be not able to do that thing which is least. Why may he be called for the rest? Consider the lilies how they grow. They toil not, they spin not. And yet I say unto you that Solomon, in all his glory, was not arrayed like one of these. If then God so clothed the grass, which is today in the field, and tomorrow cast into the oven, how much more will he clothe you? O ye of little faith, and seek not ye what ye shall eat, or what ye shall drink, neither be ye of a doubtful mind. For all these things do the nations of the world seek after, and your Father knoweth that ye need of these things, but rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sorry to rush through the scriptures, but I'm conscious of the time. So don't worry about food and clothes, because there's a lot more to life. Look at the obedience of the fowls in the air. They are equipped with everything they need. You can't add to your stature because of thought. God is our provider. Jesus says, seek after the kingdom. So that's what I'm going to do.
Amen.
I'm going to seek after the kingdom of God in my spirit. Because flesh and blood will not inherit the kingdom. You can't observe the kingdom. The kingdom has to be spiritual before it's material. Consider the lilies. They toil not, yet they are arrayed more than Solomon. Solomon was the richest man that ever lived. But the lily was arrayed in a fine garment because it was in obedience to the will of God. Amen.
Amen.
Sit that one. That belongs to me.
Yeah.
The kid would be in abundance. You can choose from everything. Except that one. Consider it. The one thing that belongs to you. It will take an adversary of your generosity to take. abundance and to focus on the lack. And that's what Satan does. He makes us focus on the lack, on what we're lacking. And what God does is allow us to focus on the abundance that we have in Him. Allowing the power of God to move in our lives starts with investing in the kingdom. Not to please men, not to put clothes on our back, but to replenish, be fruitful, and multiply. Why? Why do we want to tell people about the kingdom of God? Because we love our neighbor. Because God loves all of us. The more people that walk in Christ, the better environment we all live in. Amen?
Amen.
I love Christianity. I love walking this walk. Because you get a sense that everybody here has my best interest at heart and vice versa. Amen? And we pray one for another and we care for each other.
Amen.
And that's what brings us together. So let's fill this world with knowledge, God. That is our goal. That is our role. And this is the scripture that we read earlier. Lord, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name
in all the earth.
Who has set thy glory above the heavens. How could the mouth of babes and sucklings as thou ordained his strength because of thine enemies, that thou mightest still the enemy and the ever-living. When I consider thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the sons of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou madest him to have dominion over the works of thy hands, and thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yet all the beasts of the field, the fowl of the air, and the fish of the sea, whatsoever passeth through the parts of the seas. O Lord, our Lord,
how excellent
is thy name in all the earth. The first thing man needs to do is acknowledge the excellency of God and the work of his hands. The testimony of the believers strengthens the name of God against his enemy. We're called to be like children in our faith. God hides things from the wise and prudent and reveals them to little children. Amen. The babe and sucklings, there he was talking about, is the testimony of the believer that strengthens God. Our testimony is God's testimony.
Amen.
All we have to do is look up to the heavens and consider the magnitude of the creative power of our God's creation. The obedience that creation shows to God. What is man? Probably the most philosophical question of all time. What is man? The Bible is very clear. Man is made up of three things. Spirit, soul, and body. Man is made in the image of God and became a living soul in God's rest. He was created to till the ground of creation to prepare it for God's work. Man disobeyed God, that he became like God, knowing good and evil. The evil took place in heaven. Satan was perfect. He corrupted creation and consequently corrupted the hearts of man. Man was kicked out of the garden before he could obtain eternal life. Could you imagine if we're stuck with creation as it is? Eternity, there would be no hope. The way of the tree of life had to be protected. Man inherited the corruption of Adam. And when the corruption takes precedent in the mind of man, then we come into condemnation. For they are after the flesh that do the things of the flesh. The carnal This is why God's name is excellent. He has given man stewardship over creation. I reckon that the sufferings of this present time will be
able to compare with
the glory that shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature waits for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to reality, not willingly, but by reason of him who has subjected the same
in hope.
Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God.
Sons of God.
For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain
together
until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves grow within ourselves, waiting for the adoption to wit,
the redemption
of the body. Although we may be suffering in this present time, and the earth may be suffering, we are called to be obedient to the will of God. We have an opportunity to take part in the original plan for man, which is eternal life. The plan for the world was for it to be full of the knowledge of God. It is within the kingdom of God that man fulfills his purpose, which is yielding to God as the king of the universe. It's relationship and obedience to God through Christ that glory is revealed in us. When we suffer with Jesus as our Savior, we are glorified in Jesus, and Jesus is glorified in us.
Amen.
Creation is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God.
Amen.
Who are the sons of God? The sons of God is anyone that is led by the Spirit. Creation is waiting for us. If you want to redeem creation, we need to start winning souls, producing fruits, replenishing the earth and multiplying it. God's kingdom is at hand. It's not something that we have to wait until death for. We can obtain it right now. The kingdom of heaven is within. Once the Spirit bears witness of our spirit, we are children of God and joint heirs with Christ, that we may be glorified together. The creature loved himself by the subjection of God. God cursed creation in hope that the creature would return to him in humble obedience.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. Praise God.
See, the world is in a bad way. Although we may have peace in the mystery of God, as the first fruits of the Spirit, we present ourselves as a living sacrifice to God. Even ourselves, we groan and travail in wait for the adoption. We will be healed from all our infirmities.
Amen. No more pain.
And the righteousness shall be the girdle of his loins, and faithfulness the girdle of his reins. The wolf also should dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion, and the fatted together, and the little child shall lead them, and the cow and the bear shall feed, and the young one shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like an ox.
Hallelujah.
And the sucking child shall play on the hole of the ass. The weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all
my holy hill.
For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, and as the waters cover the sea.
Thank you, Jesus.
Isaiah is prophesying of the coming Messiah. And the new age where peace is found. This is world through Christ Jesus. Christ's kingdom is an eternal kingdom that will destroy the other kingdoms. The other kingdom is God that cannot be destroyed. We are set apart from the world, absent from the body,
and present in the Lord.
In the Lord's presence is where we should make decisions. Whether it be regarding the environment or any other matter, we should seek His guidance on how to best steward His creation during this present time.
Thank you.
The obedience, blessings, and security. The Lord in His holy temple, the Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, His eyelids test the sons of men. Revelation
22.
And He showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding out of the throne and of the land. In the midst of the street of it, and in either side of the river, the tree of life, which bears 12 manner of fruits, yielding a fruit every month, and the leaves of the tree of the healing of the nations.
Healing of the nations.
And there shall be no more curse.
Hallelujah.
For the throne of God and all the land shall be in it, and His servants shall serve Him, and they shall see His face, and His name shall be in their foreheads, and there shall be no night. And there be no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them
light,
and they shall reign for ever and ever. God watches everything. He watches from the heavens. So we need to make inquiry constantly regarding His will. The water represents the knowledge of God, which feeds the tree of life. Either side of the river was the tree of life, bearing 12 manner of fruits on either side. The curse that man inherited is now finished. God has got what He wanted. He has man's heart. He has dominion over heaven. And only those who are redeemed through His Son are to partake in the splendor of God's life. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts.
Lord God Almighty.
All earth is full of His glory.
Thank you.
And I'd like to close there, and I'd say, just to summarize, you know, the world will tell us a lot of